Today we're diving into the world of gaming with a focus on the Intel Core i5-7600K. In this video, we'll explore how this CPU holds up in today's modern gaming landscape. So grab your snacks, settle in, and let's see if the i5-7600K still has what it takes to power your gaming rig in 2024. Hi there, fellow gamers, and welcome back to Nelly's Nerd Cave, your go-to destination for all things tech and gaming. Today, we're taking a deep dive into the world of gaming performance as we put the trusty 7600K CPU to the test with three different GPUs, the GTX 970, the GTX 1650, and the RTX 3060. First up, let's talk about the powerhouse. The CPU, the i5-7600K. With its quad-core architecture and impressive clock speeds, this CPU has been a staple in gaming rigs for many years now. But how well does it hold up against the latest and greatest GPUs? That's what we're here to find out today. For today's setup, I'll be using this, the Asus H110M-A/M.2 motherboard. With its H110 chipset, it makes this a simple yet effective board to use across many different applications. I will also be using two Corsair Vengeance DDR4 memory modules with 8GB on each. Each one is 3200MHz, giving us 16GB. And let's not forget about keeping the CPU cool under pressure. We've enlisted the help of the Thermal Right Assassin King, if I can find it. This is the 120SE CPU cooler, boasting 5 heat pipes for maximum cooling efficiency. This has shown to be an excellent cooler for the £19 I spent on this device. With this, I'll also be using the Kioxia Xeria 480GB SSD, which has shown to be a really good drive for my needs and testing. And the final thing that we need to test all these things is a monitor. It's this one behind me, it's the MSI G271. It's 145Hz and 1080p. Why am I using 1080p, I hear you cry? Well, the Steam hardware survey shows that most of you out there are still using 1080p as your gaming resolution. Now, before we jump into the gaming benchmarks, let's take a closer look at our contenders. First of all, the GTX 970. This one is the MSI Gaming 4G. It's a 4GB GDDR version with a clock speed of 1279MHz. This is a veteran of its time and still holds its own against some modern titles. Next up, we have the GTX 1650. Known for its budget-friendly price tag and respectable performance, this particular one is from Palette and is the Game Pro OC. With its 4GB of GDDR6 and a clock speed of 1410, the 1650 is still sold today in some 12th gen gaming machines. And finally, we have the RTX 3060. Boasting cutting-edge features and unmatched graphical prowess, this MSI one is the Ventus 2X. It comes with a whopping 12GB of GDDR6 and a clock speed of 1807MHz, making this a superb graphics card. Now, we've got all these parts together, let's dive into the build. We'll be right back. So now the build's complete, let's jump into the gaming benchmarks and see how each GPU stacks up with the i5-7600K CPU. We'll be testing my usual array of synthetic and real gaming, so again using 3D Mark TimeSpy and Doom Eternal to get a comprehensive understanding of the gaming performance across these three cards. As we will see from the benchmarks, each GPU offers its own unique strengths and weaknesses when paired with the i5-7600K CPU. The GTX 970 may be showing its age in some of the newer titles, but it still holds its own in many games. In 3D Mark TimeSpy on this processor, we see that it has great frame rates of between 19 and 25 frames per second, which is pretty good for a 10-year-old graphics card. While playing Doom Eternal, it fares pretty well in gameplay with frame rates of 41 and 51 frames per second. The final score in 3D Mark TimeSpy for this particular graphics card was 3548, which is about 200 points less than the average. Could be something to do with the OBS that I'm using as a capture device. Moving on to the GTX 1650, this surprises with its performance given its budget-friendly price point. In 3D Mark TimeSpy, we see it has frame rates of between 19 and 24 frames per second, which is about the same as the GTX 970. This gives us a final score of 3425, again 80 points less than the average result, but 120 points less than the GTX 970. While in Doom Eternal, it does fare with really good frame rates of between 39 and 55. And finally, while the RTX 3060 shines with its impressive frame rates and ray tracing capabilities, with an increase of frame rates in both tests, 3D Mark TimeSpy came out with a final score of 6567, which is 52% better than both of the other two cards. They had frame rates of between 45 and 60 frames per second overall within 3D Mark TimeSpy, and it shows its massive superiority when we get to use it with Doom Eternal, where it does exceptionally well in gameplay with frame rates in excess of 104 frames per second. So which GPU reigns supreme when paired with the i5-7600K? Well, it ultimately depends on your budget and the gaming preferences that you're using. While the GTX 970 itself and the GTX 1650 offer respectable performance for their price points, the RTX 3060 undoubtedly steals the show with its unmatched graphical fidelity and performance. With a price tag of around about £289, this is one to look out for if you're in the market for a potential upgrade and want to go with graphics first. So there you have it, folks. That's me completed for this episode. Thanks for tuning in to Nelly's Nerd Cave. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe for more tech and gaming content. And until next time, happy gaming and stay nerdy.